Okay, so who is winning? The Scientologist or the Watchtower? Well, to start off, I do think the logo of the Scientologist is interesting. L. Ron Hubbard, he did know Aleister Crowley, but a lot of people knew Crowley in the 50s and 60s, and he's even on the Beatles' Sgt. Pepper's album cover. Crowley started out in a steer. Christian household where birthdays and other celebrations were prohibited, and they believed that one must live a humble life in spite of the family having a lot of money. Later, when he got a little older, he started trekking around the globe, spending his inheritance, and he joined the Golden Dawn. Yet there were conflicts, and he left and formed his own practice called the Lima. It's been said that L. Ron Hubbard copied many of the teachings of the Lima when he formed his own church of Scientology. But the symbology the Scientologists use today is really from the Golden Dawn and other teachings that came from that order. The Golden Dawn symbolism is used on the Scientology logo. It's part of the lesser banishing ritual of the hexagram, banishing Saturn hexagram of fire. The elements of fire in the east. Fire consumes. One triangle consuming the other for the fire hexagram, and you can see the S for Scientology deeply entwined in the hexagram. It's just the traditional hexagram, but it's inverted, with one triangle consuming the other, like fire consumes paper or wood or whatever material that burns. The lesser banishing ritual, the hexagram, is supposed to rid your area, your space, your home of unwanted influences from the higher planes. Then we move on to the Jehovah's Witnesses logo. Now, they use more the traditional basic Masonic design of the shades of blue, meaning eternity and immortality, with the pale blue associated with peace. The blue and white denotes a master grade of third degree Mason. You must obtain the grade of third degree before you can proceed to higher knowledge or other grades or positions in the various orders or fraternities. I'm sure most JWs and ex-JWs have heard the Watchtower is now building a huge new media center in Ramapo, New York, which is not far from their current headquarters in Warwick. But the Scientologists have had their huge media center since about 2016, when they purchased an old Hollywood studio in Los Angeles. And they film all kinds of productions, their own training videos, recruiting videos. They have Scientology television and online courses to study from their website. It's interesting that the JWs were doing online Bible studies, but stopped since they're sending their recruiters door to door again. And I suspect the Watchtower was not profiting from offering online Bible studies, so they dropped whatever does not bring them cash. So, in my opinion, I think the Scientologists are winning and are much farther along than the Jehovah's Witnesses, even though the JW started first, maybe 50 years before the Scientologists started their religion. Yet I think the Scientologists have a better business model. They are more slick and professional. They do have a governing body, yet that one front man who sort of tries to resemble Tom Cruise is out in front, while the JWs have those aged relic old men of the governing body. They push in the spotlight. No one is joining to meet a bunch of aged men playing God while they gander at the new boys out of high school that volunteer to be slaves for them at HQ. And now they'll be vying for a spot at the new JW Media Center once that's completed and will house a bunch of young worker bees for Jehovah. Of course, both of these organizations, they ferret out your unconscious anxiety so they can exacerbate them. So it can make you more emotionally unwell because anxious, neurotic people make better consumers and better churchgoers. Notice the imagery that the Jehovah's Witnesses use. They play on everyone's basic fear of death. The young are not so worried about this and can act fearlessly, The older you get, the more you face your own mortality and think you need a religious organization to save you from death and eternal destruction. Some people have wondered why the JWs don't put good-looking people on JW broadcasting. How come the governing body are a collection of bizarre specimens? The old and ugly men of the governing body are just that, old and ugly. Then what's flashed before your eyes? Beautiful scene of a paradise on earth. Beautiful paintings are in the Watchtower publications and the study articles online on JW.org. Beautiful young men and women in a paradise. This is intentional. It plays on our fears of getting old and ugly and suffering from illness and waiting to die without hope. The JWs do not give you any hope at all. You will age and die. That's it. Unless these aged men in the organization grant you life, meaning that you die and approve JW in good standing. They have taken the place of God and Christ in the church, and the membership believe it. So, after all that ugly of the governing body, they like to flash before you in their magazines and videos, beautiful people in the paradise as a stark contrast. This is intentional. No matter how old you are, how young you are, when you see people getting old or aged, you know that's where you're headed. So, here comes the images of the JW paradise. It's where gay people turn straight. No one's anointed because they're all in heaven or headed there. Everyone is already trained to sit around and wait for a meeting to start in a local kingdom hall. So why turn to making more videos? Why does a Watchtower need a huge new media center? When viewers see a symbol inserted into a film, the event draws up memories of past encounters with that symbol and of any messages or themes attached to that symbol. This is often what some people call unconscious or subliminal process, but some call it unreflective for the reason that most people are just not paying attention to the influences that affect them deeply. So Watchtower throws a lot in their videos to trigger the viewer and see what fear they can exploit. Their portrayal of the new system, the JW paradise on earth, makes you think you can't do this right now. They make you feel guilty if you go for a walk, if you walk your dog, fly a kite, or have a picnic. Their message is that now is a time to be recruiters and work for the Watchtower without compensation. Delay doing anything in your life, unless it's to give up your life to their God, Jehovah. That's how they play on your fear. Oh, I feel guilty because I didn't try to recruit someone today, when you first need to take care of yourself and plan your future. The JWs also mimic the Last Supper, where all of Jesus' disciples were white males. Only after receiving complaints from prominent African-American families did the JWs allow a black man on the governing body. But so far, no other men have been allowed from diverse racial demographics, such as Asian, East Indian, or American Indian. The Watchtower feels that those countries or that demographic, they wouldn't be part of their religion anyway, so why bother? All they care about is recruiting more free labor into the organization with a promise of everlasting life that they can't give. They place themselves above God and Christ. Now we see video number 27, showing the adventures of the indoctrination of Caleb and Sophia. We see the blatant use of butterflies and a monarch butterfly landing on Sophia's hand. She dreams of a butterfly garden in the new system. Right, because the alleged MKUltra mind control programming of any monarch slave will have the imagery of the monarch butterfly. I mean, how obvious. Sophia dreams of having a butterfly garden in the JW paradise, and a monarch butterfly is featured prominently. Then we have her friend, I believe, is resurrected to the new system with blue butterflies. Butterflies are a symbol of transformation, a metamorphosis into a new altar, a new personality, like the caterpillar to a cocoon, dormancy and inactivity to a butterfly, new creation. Part of the slave mind control is black and white programming. Being gay is wrong no matter what. Abortion is wrong no matter what the circumstances. There is no empathy for individuals in their own personal circumstance. With Jehovah's Witnesses, there's no gray area. It's black and white thinking. We are labeled good or bad by a governing body and the elders in each congregation. One of the outgrowths of SRA upon the monarch victim is that they will generally exhibit black and white thinking. Black and white thinking is an element of the religious spirit, which in spiritual terms pervades the monarch victim. The monarch victim system is set up to usurp true faith. Something has to replace true faith, and the religious spirit is a good substitute. Perfectionism or unloving idealism is a part of the religious spirit. This perfectionism will demand that if a person cannot be perfect, they should just give up. The religious spirit has stopped many victims of monarch programming from moving forward to real freedom. It's a powerful type of spirit. Many people are waiting until they are perfect to help minister to others. This is the outgrowth of the religious spirit. We do not need to be perfect to help others. Start by recognizing your own fear triggers that lay dormant inside of you since you left the watchtower. See if you can ferret those out and destroy them, taking back your power. Then you can transform away from the mind control of a JW monarch slave, whether you're male or female, and program it into a new, free, spirited phoenix rising out of the ashes of a crumbling watchtower.